Bitch Talkers, episode 170. That's Sherelle. She didn't mean to turn you on. That's, who did this before, or after her? Palmer. Anyone know in here? Nobody knows.
Sudi.
No. You don't know? Didn't mean to turn you on?
Oh, yeah, I know this, but who did it after?
Yeah.
No.
White dude. Palmer.
Addicted to Love.
Yes.
Addicted to Love. Oh.
Anyways, someone will think of it.
Might as well face
Robert
it. Robert.
Yes.
Okay.
So anyway. Sherelle did it first, then Robert Palmer. Thank you.
Anyway.
Alzheimer's.
That was a team effort. I liked it.
It was. That's why I looked at both of you. So it's the Bitch Talk Podcast. How are you? We're episode 170. Really quickly, this is the last time. I have to run this promo, and I'm really sad. It's CamFest 35 in San Francisco. It's an 11-day celebration of film, music, and food, running March 9th through the 19th. We are happy to co-present a series called Brown Girls at the Alamo Draft House in the Mission, March 16th, 6:30 p.m. I know it's sold out, but if you go and you stand in the rush line, that means that whoever doesn't show up that already bought tickets, you can buy a ticket and go and sit in and watch the series and meet us and have booze right before St. Patty's Day. So
super excited. It's going to be so fun.
Come through. Brown Girls has been really great to us. They started reposting our stuff on their Facebook wall. They're following Bitch Talk. Thank you. And yeah, it's been a great, great little cooperative for this promo. So if you can, come visit. Otherwise, it sounds like we're going to be in Reno maybe in September. September, April, and or May. So
I go every month, so.
Right?
Well, you need a new laptop, so.
Yeah, I got to find a way to pay for that.
Yeah, craps table. Perfect.
So, you know, we're doing a little basic bitch talk here, and I have a few articles. We haven't done this in a while where I just had to run a show and been like, blah, 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 this is happening. What do you guys think? But I did read, and I don't know if you guys have, that Alec Baldwin might be hanging up his red tie and stop playing Trump on SNL.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
No, I did not see that.
I felt a little like, this is their thing, SNL. Like, this is what they're leading with. Or this is their kind of punch to their SNL skits every...
Maybe he's realizing what a long road this is doing, because he's got so much material.
It's too much.
Is it maybe he has other projects he'd rather work on? Because there are a lot of people impersonating Trump, though. I've seen a lot of them, a lot of really good ones. So fine in that sense.
Can I make a little side note to what you're saying is, I had no idea until I saw the story and was reading, because I'm limiting my news feed because I just can't every day and day or night look at what this guy is doing. But I did not know that he's not going to be a part of the correspondents dinner at all.
Oh, yeah.
He's not going.
That. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know.
Yeah.
So I guess there's a whole call out to a bunch of people that impersonate him to host it.
Oh my God. That's fucking incredible.
And I didn't.
He's the first president, the only president other than Reagan. And it was because Reagan had been shot and was recovering from that.
No comment.
To ever not.
I'm not encouraging violence. Anyways, okay.
No, what I'm saying, they all show up because every president realizes the importance of the media. They're what keeps you honest,
right?
They're the people that keep you
and
in
they
check
have a sense of
and
humor.
Call you out on your shit, and you should be there out of respect for that and realizing the importance of that. Period. Like fucking pussy.
What's his excuse? Just I don't want to be there. I've got to play golf again. Does anyone know?
I don't think that he gave a valid excuse.
He just said, I won't be there. Sorry.
Yeah, he's like, I won't be. Yeah, I read his statement, but it wasn't. It was just that fucking just
bullshit.
Words. It didn't really mean anything.
I'll be in Florida.
It didn't mean anything.
Playing golf with Vladimir
Putin.
And
how much shit did he talk about Obama playing golf too much in his presidency? And
we
he's
won't
played
even go to
already
the wire
played
tapping
so
bullshit.
Much more. Oh, and
anyways,
He could. He
Obama
should sue
should.
Him for libel. Like
I already asked that question, but he's a public figure. He can't sue him.
Mm.
It's just you can't. Anyways, Obama should just.
He wouldn't because he's not.
Obama should appear just, in spite of him not going.
He should give. He should. Yeah. He should.
He should go in person
as president, like acting president, pretend he's still the president. Oh, that'd be awesome, and have your boy Keegan.
Oh God. fun.
As a angry Obama. Anyway,
Obama. So yeah, Alec Baldwin. He actually said, I'll pull up the CNN thing that I saw.
Yeah, I didn't see that.
He was saying, blah blah blah. I might tire it. His policies aside, which you can hate, I thought he would have just relaxed. Baldwin says the maliciousness of this White House is people worried. That's why I'm not going to do it much longer. The impersonation, I don't know how much more people can take it. And Baldwin adds, Trump just overwhelmingly lacks any sportsmanship. He remains bitter and angry, and you just want to look at him and go, you won. Like, just, you know, be a good sportsman. Go ahead.
I don't know. I kind of respect that. I would imagine it's kind of like disgusting to kind of play this character that you hate, of a real person that you hate. I don't know. Would that be taxing on you, you know, to like really study somebody and have to like reiterate these words of somebody that you hate? I don't know, because he's come out before and said, look, my impersonations are not impersonations. I'm saying word for word what this guy says. Like, I'm just reenacting literally what he does. So maybe it's just been really taxing on him, and it kind of like magnifies the effect of Trump. I don't know.
I just think the humor, but the reality, I don't know.
Humor is healing.
But it's also like, it's so funny that it's not funny anymore because it's real. So, I mean, I don't know. I read that and I was surprised because this has been a big pull and a big push for Baldwin's career, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, he's fine, but this puts him on television at least once every other week, if not every 2 weeks. So it's interesting. We'll see. I mean, even Dump has tired at Alec Baldwin out.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to impersonate him anymore.
Yeah.
He's exhausted. That's
interesting, but there are so many really good Trump impersonators for them to rise up to.
Is there? I don't know who else even does him as well as he does.
I've seen a few, but yeah.
It's something that's come up sort of on this podcast a few times. And then finally this week, it was, I mean, WikiLeaks, whatever, but the whole CIA wiretapping, that it's happening and it's been happening, is real. I got a little paranoid about this a few years ago when I saw the documentary Citizen 4 about Edward Snowden. And when he talked about, I have my phone up now and I want to turn it over, but when he talked about the stuff that he was in tune with in terms of intelligence, you know, on your laptops with your camera and on your phones, turning them off at night, or turning them off in general when you're having, you know, whatever kind of conversations, because they're listening. And so after I watched that, I was like, fuck, I need to turn my GPS off. I have my sticker over my camera, my laptop.
That's what I was going to ask you. Yeah.
And I've had that on there. And, you know, this week it came to fruition that that's happening. And that happened under Obama. So I'm not, you know, I'm not throwing Dump under this this truck, but it's happening. And the WikiLeaks article, you can go find it, talks about it's Apple iPhones, Google Android phones, which I have one, Samsung TVs, which I have one, and has a hidden microphone in them, and Microsoft Word.
Awesome.
So I don't even know where to go from there, because we all have these things. I mean, Char's looking for a laptop. I mean, at this point, Char, you should probably just send letters to people if you don't want it.
Yeah, let's bring back the wax seal. Letters, wax seal, feather pens.
Feather pens. What's the
yeah, Morse code.
Morse code. I think I'm gonna go move somewhere.
I don't know, because
and bring out Morse
based
code.
On my
for
real,
you guys.
Based on my recent experience. Actually, the
oh
stuff,
yeah, your notepad.
The
is...
stuff that's more important to me, the stuff that's actually affecting me more, are like the physical things that I've written out. You know, like my invoices and my notebook and my folders that had information in it. Those are the things, a checkbook of all the things that got stolen out of my bag. The checkbook has had the biggest impact on me because they tried to write fraudulent checks. So,
but you had someone supporting you, which is your bank.
Yes.
And they're like, oh, by the way, this is happening. Like, this shit that I'm talking about is, like, super secret. They may pull shit from whatever you're doing.
That's true.
And I'm only bringing that up, too, because it was just a couple weeks ago where you went to Disneyland, and we talked about it, I think, off mic. And I think Ange and I went out afterwards, or we did something, and I'm like, look at the stuff that just came up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What the fuck was it? Yeah, it was like a picture or an advertisement for
Disney World and Disneyland. I'm like, I never punched that into my phone, never did anything, but they're listening.
And well, we Ange just was talked all, about it, yeah.
What the fuck?
I freaked out. Yeah.
I'm like, I'm serious that this is happening. it's happening.
Well, and I feel like I don't realize it enough because I don't go on social media as much. And that's when you see like the effects of what you're talking about and what you're searching.
Or in a search.
Is when you go,
search.
Or even on a website on your phone.
Yep.
And then you're like, those little side advertisements. And it's like, what? How do you know
I didn't look for it. We talked about it. Yeah. And that's what was more scary.
Yeah. Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
No,
right after we recorded, she had that on her phone.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, like something similar to, I don't know if it was Disneyland, but it was something along those lines. And I remember telling my sister-in-law going, look at what's coming up on my phone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel like that when I send text messages to other people. I mean, like, what? Like, you know, like when I'm, you know, like, you know, private conversations and I'm like, oh my God. Because you know what I think about? I think, I don't know if you guys ever watched it, The Good Wife. There was, there were a lot of storylines in there about the NSA?
Yeah,
National Security.
Where they're listening to, like, where they basically, there's people, like, there's cubicles of people.
Just listening
to cell phone conversations and stuff. So
fuck you if you're listening. God damn.
I don't know. I don't know anymore, guys. That's why I'm podcasting. I mean, I'll put it out there, but if I wake up and my phone has, you know, weird advertisements for stuff I was talking about and not looking up, that's where I'm like, I don't know anymore. Mm-hmm. I don't know. And you can look on WikiLeaks and as much as I hate their founder, I mean, they are putting out the truth. But if you want to see the documentary about Snowden, I highly recommend it.
Oh, yeah.
Citizen 4. HBO. It came out in 2014. And the stuff that he's talking about is the stuff that's finally kind of coming out about what's going on. And the interesting thing is about the Apple iPhones and the Android phones and all these, the Samsung TVs, which scares me. I'm like, I have that flat screen. I guess there's something called 0 days. And those are names for bugs or exploits that are commonly referred to as 0 days, a name given to bugs or other issues with a piece of technology that the original manufacturer doesn't know about yet. I'm like, how do they not know? 0 days are essentially problems within a machine or system that the manufacturer has had 0 days to fix. So whether within an app or an iPhone or Microsoft Word, hackers can use it to break in. Like, so are they not checking the stuff that goes out? You know what I mean? Like,
wow.
0 days. So that shit's, but who's putting it in there?
Yeah.
That's my question. I'll switch topics really
Thanks.
Quickly. Yeah, hey, it's out there. Well, I've talked about it. I've talked about the Instagram pictures that I had posted.
That and look exactly like, yeah.
What you posted.
Yeah.
Which freaks me out.
Well, still, there's no reasonable answer for why I keep getting penis enlargement emails.
Yes, there
I never
is.
Talk
sure
about that. I've
you
never
are right
suggested
now.
Them.
Your phone's open.
Okay, so now, yeah. But I have never talked about or suggested them, and I get penis enlargement emails
are
for like
sure?
the past
like a
5 years.
Night, there wasn't someone that mentioned it, and now it's just in your phone? You don't know.
No, okay, maybe.
It might have been Sunday night at my birthday. You don't know.
Yep, me and your mom. We're talking about penis enlargement, probably. God. No, this was like 5 years ago this started.
Okay, well, really quickly, hearkening back to episode, 169, talking about my birthday?
Yeah.
Really quickly, when your friend came in the bar and you guys were talking and you were feeling very loving, my mom was like, "Hey, Erin," and making the eyes towards him and you. And I was like, "Oh, yeah, that's her dude." It was hilarious because she just thought it was some rando. And I'm like, well, that still would have been the
why,
same.
What was weird? It was
you were
weird
putting hands in places and being very friendly.
Oh.
Friendlier than not.
Oh, and she didn't know that I...
No, I haven't talked about this.
Oh, yeah, no,
you're
that's
very
fine.
On the DL about this stuff, so...
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I just live my life.
But my mom did this. I know it because... And I was like, oh, yeah, that's her dude. It's totally fine.
She thought I was just hopping on warm body.
Yeah.
I had a second of that when he first got there. When he first got there. And then I was just like, ooh. Yeah. And then I went.
What? No.
And then I realized.
At least Char didn't make the eyebrows.
Well, because and then I don't really talk about. Yeah, I just kind of personal. And then very personal.
No, and then
Mr. As Party, opposed to the not Captain Party, Mr.
The
Party.
The thing is like I knew that there was a friend. So it was like, so immediately it was just like, oh, okay, that's the friend. But you know, I wasn't.
But you didn't know at first, because he could have been a guy that just came in to listen to bluegrass and then
now
just sidled up to this one.
Who's had brown ass. From bluegrass to brown ass.
Who's had some brown liquor for like 5 hours and playing pool and feeling hot.
No. I'm very private. Contrary to popular bitch talk belief.
Char, he's got a guy too in Reno.
I mean, that was like the first thing you said to Char, which was hilarious.
Well, because I knew that he's a member of the same
club.
Casino club that your guy works for, so that's why I was like really excited to introduce you to, because it's gonna happen. We're all gonna be there. We're all gonna be working the tables.
You did that. You were introducing him to people that hadn't met him before, and he was saying hi to everybody, and then I was like sitting because I was kind of like, you know, like in Eeyore mode, posted him on the bench, and I looked and you like looked at me and you kind of gave the I know exactly what I got to talk to you about. And he brings him by and then goes, she's got a guy.
That's all I heard was
Reno.
Guy. Hey, she's got a guy.
Where's your guy from? And then he said, he's like, oh, Grand Sierra. And you're like, that's where her guy is from. We got to go to Reno.
It's all about the guys.
You're telling your sister.
The guy.
That I had already met before. And you're like, she goes to Reno. We can play craps with her.
She plays craps. My
because
sister's
Aunt
great at craps.
Craps. I already told you.
Oh, yeah girl.
Yeah, Aunt's really good at craps. Yeah. Anyway.
That
whatever.
Rhymes.
Yeah, well, it was all true. Those are all facts. And I was excited to share.
With Char?
With everyone.
Sharing with Char?
Yeah.
That could be a new new segment on Bitch Talk. Quickly, because it's spring and baseball is coming. I'm really excited. There's something, I'm excited, but I'm not excited because beer, allegedly at AT&T Park, by the way, we're in San Francisco.
Don't
so
tell me
the
it's
Giants.
Raised prices.
Oh, no. Yeah. Girl.
It was already like $15 for Bud Light.
No, I don't think it is. Now it's going to be $15.
Yeah,
so I think
it was probably
like,
12.
Right.
It was more than 10.
My 8-ounce glass of red wine, because I was always like, oh my God, thank God for those bartenders. They'll fill it all the way to the top where I'm like, I have to sip it before I even move it. It's like $12 for a glass of red wine. So, you know, things at AT&T Park are rising. But, you know, just bring in some food and bring in whatever you want to bring in.
Yeah.
Or whatever you can.
No,
I mean, I don't really recommend that. But
yeah,
you know,
me neither.
Whatever you need to get by at the park because you're poor like we are and just trying to live our lives, do it.
You pre-party. You do what you got
to
do.
Go to Tony's where I took Char
or the High
last
Dive
year.
Or
yeah.
Go Reds.
Yes. You can even bring in food there, by the way.
Into the park?
Yeah. I do that all the time. I used to bring in McDonald's before they knocked it down.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That is kind of sad.
Primo Patio. Char, have you been there?
No.
Oh, girls. We're going to go there. Okay. Jerk chicken sandwich is the best.
What the fuck?
Yeah,
give me that.
And french fries.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want
it's
that.
Delicious.
Where is that?
Oh, just like a block down.
Okay.
They have a patio. It's beautiful.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Tell me when. Let's get tickets. Let's go.
Yeah, all right.
Let's do this.
Yeah, when
Are you
for
dying
a while.
Over there?
I don't know what's wrong with
okay.
me. It might be the whiskey.
It might be 40.
No, the whiskey helps. Give me a break.
That's true. It clears everything up.
Exactly.
What were you going to say about the...
No, I was going to say there was I go to about 30-ish games a year.
Do you really?
Yeah. Wow.
And that's all impressive. Of the last couple years.
But for baseball, that's season, like 1/8 of the season.
Yeah. last season was slow because I was so busy with the company and stuff. And right. I was doing KFOG.
You were getting up at 3 in the morning.
Right.
Yes.
But, yeah. But on average, you know, like I go to at least 10 to 15 games.
Sure.
There was a couple of years, I guess, you know, like especially the high after winning the World Series and stuff like that.
The year of the World Series, I was going all the time.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So those, like,
2010.
You know,
like 2010
to about 2013, 2014.
I feel bad. I feel like maybe I'm the curse. They haven't. They never won since I've
no,
lived.
No, because Taylor not. Swift didn't write an album last
oh,
year.
Okay, thank you. I feel better about it. I'm like,
October.
What the fuck? They can't win when I'm here?
Anyways, but there was a point where I was going all the time, and then I was buying the Crazy Crab sandwiches. And then I was...
Those are definitely going to go up this season.
Those are like $20.
No, they're $17 right now.
Yeah. Oh, $17.
Yeah, and when I first started buying them, they were like $14.
Maybe $12.
So...
Sure, 30 of those a season?
Well, I wasn't...
Like
well, that was the thing.
It's
about halfway
like.
Through the season. I was like, I'm paying more for these goddamn sandwiches than I am
for my ticket. Yeah.
Yep. So then I started getting, you know, I'd go to Little Caesars and get Crazy Bread.
And pretend like it was Crazy Crab
and Subway
crab sandwich.
Yeah, and Subway sandwiches.
Crazy
and
bread, Crazy Crab, same shit.
All right.
And what are you looking at?
The computer's kind of acting kind of slow.
Uh-oh. Okay.
I hope it's not, you know, making a sound. I hope it's not making a sound choppy.
Okay.
But anyways.
Should we talk a little choppy and then a little balance?
God, I think you made it look like that.
Anyways, baseball is happening, and there is the World Baseball Classic happening. And I'm bringing this up because Ange is here. We've been to Israel. Team Israel is doing really well.
Wow.
In the World Baseball
wow.
Classic.
Good for them.
With the help of former A's players, Oakland A's players.
That were
that
Israeli
are Israeli.
And now live there and decided to play out there? Or what? How do you end
up? You know,
there?
I don't know how the World Baseball Clinic or Classic really decides who can be there. Maybe it's just your last name. Like, because my last name's Lim, I could either do China or Korea. I have no idea. So I thought it was interesting. It's the first time the team has ever made it to the World Baseball Classic. They beat out Great Britain, Pakistan, and Brazil in the September qualifier. Oakland A's players that are helping Team Israel include Ike Davis. I know that name. Nate Freeman, Sam Fold, and Nick Rickles, like Don Rickles.
Oh.
But I thought it's interesting. I'm like, we were in Israel, baseball's not a thing.
No, nothing.
At all.
I didn't see a lot of sports, period, just except for soccer. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, so go Team Israel.
Yeah,
and
why
the
not?
Oakland A's.
Via the A's.
Yeah,
yeah?
Well,
why not?
It's a baseball. It's a Bay Area thing.
I wonder how, do you happen to notice how Cuba is in that spectrum?
No.
Baseball is huge
well,
in
yeah,
Cuba.
Well, yeah, and Korea, and yeah. Japan.
I would love to see that. I just thought it was really ironic because, like, at the time, you know, we're still, like, the embargo and everything, but they love baseball, which is the American
the uniter.
Sport. Yeah, so it was interesting to me how much they love baseball. But 40, anyway.
45 can't dump on that shit. Not yet. Yeah. He doesn't care. Doesn't make him money, so it doesn't matter. Sorry. Mm-hmm. So I guess that brings me to our favorite person's minute, which
I'm.
Have mercy.
A couple weeks ago, I'll show you her face later. A couple weeks ago, John posted. I guess there's a hashtag called rejected selfies, where if you keep your rejected selfies, then you can post them. Whatever. Sometimes, John, you know, you don't have to be with the kids all the time. You can just be yourself. Because honestly, Bitch Talk started talking about you like 4 years ago before you were really a thing. Just saying.
Yeah.
So now it's like, you know, just be you, man. Just be you. But there's a hashtag called Rejected Selfies. He posted some rejected selfies a few weeks ago on his Twitter feed. And one of them looks like his actual face is peeling off, which is whatever. It was kind of weird. But you can look them up on his Twitter feed. And yeah, that's it for 170 of the Bitch Talk podcast, which is crazy. We're close to 200, you guys. So thanks for listening. As always, you can always email us. We are therealbtpod@gmail.com. You can find us at Twitter at Bitch Talk Pod, Facebook Bitch Talk Podcast, and Instagram Bitch Talk Podcast. Listen, share, repeat, and
bitch please.
See you later.